Hey everyone, Daniel here from Twin Bytes with another quick tutorial for you, this time on dismantling a hard drive. Now you're going to need a couple of Torx screwdrivers, and I tried to show you quickly in this one part, but you couldn't see it very well. There are T7 and a T8 that you're going to need. Now there's six screws at the top here that are exposed, so we'll remove those six screws. Once they're removed, we want to feel around the label to find a hidden screw. And there's always at least one in here. Usually I can poke the screwdriver right through and unscrew it right out of there. Now I felt another one, but it turns out that it's only just an air hole. So I'm checking around to see if there's anything else, but there isn't. So we just got that one other screw that was hidden that we want to remove. Now that it's removed, we want to pry apart the top cover. So using the knife that we used earlier seems to work well. Now that we got the hard drive exposed, we want to take that out, but first we're going to take off this motherboard portion at the back. So you can see that comes off real easy. There's nothing else to remove at the back, so we're going to now tackle the insides here. Now there's a whole bunch of screws here holding this disc platter in place, and then there's a couple of screws holding the head in place as well. So we're going to first try and remove the head so we can get at the disc platter. So there's a couple of screws there. And the top plate of the head assembly comes off, but that's not magnetic. In some cases it is magnetic, but this one has no magnetic part to it. So we're gonna see if we can remove this, but there's another screwdriver that was the T7 that I didn't have earlier, and I didn't find out I needed that until now. So now we're able to remove the other screws. And sometimes prying this out comes out easy, and then you can take out the disc. But in this case, I'm having a bit of a trouble, so I'm gonna end up having to do it in the reverse order. Now that I got that top cover off of the disc, I have something else in the way here. So I gotta take that screw out, and I'll be able to pop out that little orange piece. And now I can remove the disc platter fairly easily, as the head's not really in the way too much and all the screws are removed. And this is where all your data is stored magnetically on this disc. So if you want it to destroy your data, that's where it is, all on this little disc. Now I want to remove the head assembly. It should pull out fairly easily here. And once that's out, I can remove the bottom portion of the head assembly, which has a very powerful magnet. And that's great for charging your screwdrivers or anything else that you'd like to use a very powerful magnet for. You can see, sort of in this video, how powerful it is. I'm trying to demonstrate a couple ways, but it's hard to really see in the video how powerful this magnet truly is. Now I'm going to just take out this head assembly, which has a couple more screws to remove, and show you a close-up of the actual head that reads the data on the disk platter. If you ever go to a data recovery lab and they say you need a head replacement, this is the head. It's got a little needle on the end, which is kind of hard to tell in this video, but that reads the data kind of like a record player, if you're old enough to recall what a record player is. And the disc spins around and the needle reads the data magnetically off the disc.